Hello, it is me, Cetonia. I want to talk about the Flycatcher for a bit. I think the Flycatcher is actually a really interesting ship for solo roaming. The setup that I'm running right now is 7 Tech 2 rocket launchers, an interdiction sphere launcher with the warp disruption probes. Then I'm running a dual prop setup. It's with a restrained mic warp drive, Tech 2 afterburner, the scoped scram. Fleeting Web, Kaldari Navy Medium Shield Extender, Tech 2 Ballistic Control, Tech 2 Small Bay Loading Accelerator, and Tech 2 Anti-EM Screen Reinforcement, just to plug the EM hole here. Actually has pretty decent EHP, like 8k EHP is not bad for a scram kiter that can hang out at 10k, or maybe even further if you abuse the fact that you can keep someone tackled with Bubble Plus, Heated Web, so you can actually be at like 12k. Which is a pretty interesting tactic in some matchups. But anyway, why should you fly the Flycatcher? Well, I think the Flycatcher is actually a very flexible ship. I think it's fast enough to run most gate camps due to the fact that it has dual prop and it goes 2.4k cold with MWD on. So it's actually faster than the Jackdaw. The only real disappointment in the Flycatcher, I guess, is it's quite expensive. It's a lot more expensive than you would pay for either a Seapool or a Jackdaw, and it's not as good as fighting cruisers and ARPAs the Seapool and Jackdaw are. I think you'll have a much harder time killing any kind of ratters in this, as well as any kind of cruiser matchup, just because it has a bit less raw power. But what the Flycatcher really excels at, I think, is just bringing, insane amounts of control and DPS combined. Since the Flycatcher actually gets a pretty huge bonus, it gets 10% damage per level, and it has 7 launchers to begin with. It does 335 DPS, which is pretty insane, as well as close to 400 heated. That's it. That's pretty insane DPS, I think, especially since this is DPS that you have at 10k, up to 12.4k with the missiles, and you have dual prop on top of that. The Flycatcher bonuses are pretty cool too. The Flycatcher gets an application bonus on the Kaldari Destroyer, 25% bonus to explosion radius. What this means is that already rage missiles t apply pretty well to anything that you have webbed, which is why I use rage missiles on the Kestrel. But with the Flycatcher bonus, it means you're much less vulnerable to dual prop. You can kill a dual prop Tyrannus in this pretty easily, whereas a Kestrel would probably get countered by it, or like a dual prop Dramiel. And of course, it gets the same max velocity bonus, which gives you the decent range on rockets that hit to the entirety of Heated Web range. Unfortunately, you're probably going to have to train Interdictors 5 to get the most out of this ship, unlike some of the other Dictor options, because your damage is on the Interdictors hull. 10% bonus to kinetic damage per level. That's a pretty huge bonus, especially when you consider that the Flycatcher has 7 base launchers to begin with. And it has the cool 10% reduction in Sig Bloom, which again helps you run camps a bit. This bonus only applies to kinetic, of course, so you might have a harder time killing Hecate, Jackdaw, Nu, Ishka, ships like that. Since you're going to lose a third of your DPS. If we swap over to explosive here, we'll do like 220 or something like that. Which is a lot closer to a hook bill or a normal Kestrel, I guess. Although it's, I mean, it's still respectable damage. But ideally, you want to use kinetic. Where the Flycatcher really excels, I think, is the fact that you have the bubble launcher. There are so many more kills that you can get that you couldn't otherwise get. You can guarantee that you can kill Ventures. You can guarantee that you can kill deep space transports and a lot of the cloaky haulers if you're pretty good at decloaking. You can. I think I'm actually quite comfortable with most of the T3D matchups. I think you can kill the Seapool and the Hecate pretty reliably, especially since you have dual prop. There's no way Hecate, with how slow it is, you can even gain on you. And the Seapool now, especially with the new nerf, once it's scrammed, it's really slow. You can permanently keep him at 8 to 9k, and then you have a pretty decent EHP, and you do significantly more damage than him anyway. But at that range, you're out damaging him a lot more. Jackdaw can be a hard matchup just because you're forced into shooting EM and he isn't, and he can shoot to the same range as you. If the guy is not bad, he'll be in sharpshooter mode. You can maybe kill the really bad Jackdaw sometimes, because a lot of the time what they'll do is they'll be in defensive mode or speed mode instead of sharpshooter mode, and there's a while they're in those modes, the rockets won't be able to hit you if you're kiting at 9 to 10k. I mean, you can always try a rocket Jackdaw, because as long as you don't bubble yourself, because what you can do is you can just stay at 10k since you have dual prop and you're much faster anyway, and you have the Scramble Web. If you're the Jackdaw isn't bad, you can just leave if he's actually in sharpshooter mode and shooting you properly. And the Confessor, I think you can kill it normally, just because of the fact that you have a heated AB Orbit 500 against the typical beam fit or against more brawling fits. A lot of the time they don't really have that much control, like oversized AB scram. I think you can probably kill that as well. Maybe like a more brawling orientated fit with a scram and a web would give you trouble, but I don't really see those. Anyway, I'll leave you with a pretty funny clip that I got in the ship. I think the Flycatcher is definitely one of the most underestimated interdictors. A lot of people seem to love the Saber for some reason, and this ship is way more powerful than the Saber. This can kill a Saber easy 1v1. There's like no competition. It outdamages a Saber at almost all ranges, assuming the Saber has like one gyro, one rig, and you have more control than the Saber. And you don't really, you still have like a pretty decent tank with the MSE and the EM field to plug your hole. I think the Flycatcher was pretty bad in the past when damage controls were almost always mandatory, but ever since the 33% resists got added to the structure, I think the Flycatcher benefited a lot from that, because the fact that it only has one low is you can now just always go ballistic control system. In the past, it really sucked having to choose between damage control and or BCU, because there was just a big gulf in difference between both of them. But now that you have the 33% base resistances, you can just go all damage. And man, the Flycatcher has a lot of fucking damage. Anyway, hope you enjoy the clip, and sorry for not making a video for a while. Pro Pure by Saber 4X. It's kind of fightable. Kind of. If I split them up a bit, maybe. Let's see. I think I'm going to try to make a break for the Outgate. It's actually a tackle probe. What the fuck? The 4X has a long point. The fuck is going on here, guys? Okay, well, the probe's probably gonna ram a Reno me, and then he's getting 07'd. What? They bombed their own dude, man. Look at this. The Saber's gonna get bombed. Thanks, bro. /420, bomb your Saber every day. Look, he's already half shields. And we're pretty far off now. He's not shooting me. MLG bomb, man! Fucking Black Hand Purifier right there. And had to burn my Black Hand Spy to for that kill, but it was worth it, man. MLG Purifier. I'm not sure if I can kill the 4X. He does have hammerheads though, that's a good sign. Because if I kill the hammerheads and he doesn't really have any like projected DPS maybe. And I have the AB so I should be up to 07. If he doesn't get any help, that is. And with the AB I can at least mitigate some shit from the bomber. Oh fuck, I didn't really want to reload the thing there. Oh, he has the long point anyway, right? So I don't really have to worry too much about brawling him. Because I can just MWD off. So he has web. See, he has heavy iron blasters. It's like he's plated or some kind of big tank. Maybe the purifier's back. Oh. The purifier's at a pretty decent range for me. Oh, it's dual web? Okay, that might actually be... This guy, man. This guy's the best bomber in Eve, man. And if he would have bombed, it would have helped me with the 4X. Arbitrary, that could actually be kind of dangerous. Luckily I'm 108 off the gate. But it looks like he warped directly to the fucking 4X. Guess I'll turn AB on. The 4X should die pretty soon though. I'm tracking disrupted, boys! I'm tracking disrupted! Need help! Don't want to lose this Rax. Even though I might end up burning shit out. I think I'll be able to kill this guy, but he doesn't have a point, so... I need to find a friendly citadel. That was like a pretty nice fight, man. I cannot confirm or deny this was being recorded, man. Jesus, that was fun. Oh, a hound. The best purifier in Eve. How much did that purifier actually like fuck the saver? Oh, it's like more than like 1/3 of the damage. And I think most of that is like his armor and shit that you know that's showing up. He had void loaded. If he fit to null, man, he probably could have made me run.